Hey now, Matt LaBarber Music here, and today we are talking about Sweet and Dandy, or Sweet on Dandy, by Toots and the Maytals. Amazing, super fun, funky reggae tune that I heard from the Harder They Come soundtrack. I mean, it might be on one of Toots' albums, but that's where I first heard it. It's really fun to play. We're going to have a great time learning this one. It's easier than you think. So before we zoom in and I show you how to do all of the things, I'd like to encourage you, if you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel. And if you already have, thank you so much. It really means a lot to me to know that people are watching and appreciating all the hard work that I put into making these videos and teaching you how to play the bass. So again, you know, leave me some positive feedback in the comments, like it, share it, all that stuff helps me out so much. So let's zoom in and I'll show you how to play this awesome song. So I'm going to walk you through that intro part first. It's kind of cool because it really is just using notes from a scale, from a pentatonic scale. I'll just show you what the riff is and then I'll talk to you a little bit more about the scale, okay? So it starts on the 8th fret of the D string, and then it goes to 6 on the G. Then we're going to slide from 8 to 10 on the G. So I'm going to put those all together. Okay, and that slide, you know, it's pretty quick. So we got 8, 6, slide from 8 to 10. And then we're going to play that 8-6 again, but this time it ends on 8 on the G. So all together, okay? Now you'll see when the video starts, okay, I actually come in on the second riff. And that's because I couldn't figure out how to hit play on the video. Or, you know, because it just starts up immediately. So I just had to come in on the second riff. That's my own limited technical ability. So you'll see when the video starts, I actually start with this. But it really starts with... Sorry. Okay, so far we have those two riffs. And then it goes back to riff number one again. And then it ends with this little walk down the scale. So... 8, 6, 8, and then 6 on the G, 8 on the D, 6, 4, and then we're going 6 on the A string, ending up 6 on the E. So I know that was a lot. Okay, and I'll do that regular speed and then really slow. Okay, now. Whoops. Okay, now, that's the opening riff. And for those of you that are keeping score, or that want to learn a little bit more about what it is that you're doing, that is really an E minor pentatonic scale. Minor pentatonic, or, right? Those are just notes from that scale, and then it goes down into the lower version of that scale. And if you want to mess around with that, I do have a video on the pentatonic scale that I will link you to. And I'm also just going to show you the notes and let you play around with them. Now notice, really, we're just playing around the dots, starting on the 6 of the E string. Okay? But they mix those up. it actually extends to this 10, you know? So that's that opening riff. Now that only happens at the very beginning of the song, so I spent a lot of time on it. It's very minimal, but it's a good thing to know because it'll come up again later in life. Okay. Now, this song basically just plays the same riff over and over again in three different places. I'm going to show you where you end up, okay, when you play that riff. And there is this note, which is 6 on the A string, which, if you're keeping score, is the note E flat, okay? If you're not 100% sure about which note is which, I do have a video that will tell you how to learn the notes in the fretboard. It'll help you so much, but you don't need to know that in order to play this. I'm gonna try and describe these riffs as best as possible, okay? So 6 on the A string. It would be 4 on the E or 6 on the E. So the riff really starts with, let's say, let's do this A string riff. We're gonna play 6, and then I go back a half step to 5 on the D. Then I go up to 8 on the A, 6 on the A. So it's really 6, 5, 8, 6. Okay. And again, it ends on this note on the A string, which is E flat. So I'm going to put a little thing that I followed, which has all the chords. Okay. It's either an E flat chord, which is here, A flat, which ends here, or B flat, which ends here. So before I put that up, I'll show you what the riff would sound like in those different places. Here's the E flat one. Here's the A flat one. Do you see how it's the same fingering and everything? I start in the second, which is on the fourth fret. Then I go up to 3 on the A string. Then 6 on the E. End up back on 4 on the E, which is the note A flat, okay? And then when I do that riff on B flat, it starts on 6, then it goes to 5 on the A, 8 on the E, and then 6 on the E. Now that's not the order, okay? That's just where it would be. So E flat would start here, A flat would start here, B flat would start here. Okay, now I'm going to put up this little chart that I made for myself. This is how I played along to the video and was able to do it relatively mistake-free. Okay, so you'll see that it says E flat, and if you're not familiar, flat is that little lowercase b symbol. That means flat. It means like one lower than E. And then that little kind of squiggly thing that almost looks like a percent sign, that just means you repeat the same chord. So you see E flat, we're actually going to do that 3 times, which means I play this riff 3 times. Right? And then it goes to A flat. There's 2 of those, right? And then it goes to B flat. 3 times. And that's the end of the second line. So let me play that again. E flat, A flat. Then 3 B flats. Then it goes back and plays 2 E flats. 2 A flats. And now at the end, 1 E flat, B flat, and another E flat. And that's the dancing in the bar room last night. Sorry if my singing was off key there. Okay. So, I'm gonna play the whole thing, okay? And that's like almost the entire song, okay? Just keeps going over that same pattern. So you'll notice that it speeds up and slows down a little bit, which is unfortunate, but that's just the way that it is. So I tried to keep up as best I could, but you know, you have to go with their kind of flexible timing. But it's the same set of chords over and over again. So I'm gonna play through all of them again. I'll say it out loud. E flat, E flat, E flat, A flat, A flat, B flat, B flat, B flat, E flat, E flat, A flat, E flat, B flat, E flat. And then it starts all over again, right? So now I'll do it without talking, and you can just follow along. So one, two, three, four. Of course, as soon as I tried to sing, I screwed up the rhythm. What are you gonna do? Okay. Now, the only thing that is not that, okay, that doesn't follow that pattern is the intro. And then at the end, they will do the sweet and dandy part, right? Or sweet and dandy. That is two B flats, two E flats. So B flat again is on the E string. Sweet and dandy, sweet and dandy, sweet and dandy, sweet and dandy, sweet. Okay. And I'll do that a little slower again. B flat. Really, that is the whole thing. So again, you know, I'm going to encourage, if you don't know anything about the pentatonic scale, definitely check out that video. If you don't know anything about the notes on the neck, check out that video. You can get by without any of that stuff, because hopefully I explained it pretty well. You know, that'll definitely help you if you know those things. Thanks again so much for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed learning how to play this tune and that you have fun playing along. Again, if you haven't already, please, you know, subscribe to my channel. If you already have, thank you so much. It means so much to me to know that people are watching and appreciating all the hard work that I put into making these videos. You know, again, check out mattlabarbermusic.com. See what I got coming up. And there should be something popping up right now, a different video that I've made. Check that out, too. You know, everything helps. So thank you so much. Have fun. Happy bassin'. And I will see you in the future.